Hello, hello, welcome back to my channel. Today it's another episode of the upgrading my wishlist or not so much. I do these videos every week and basically I just go through all the new makeup releases or the announced makeup releases and I'm going to see if I want to put them on my wishlist, yes or no. And this wishlist is just a list for me to curb my spending a little bit. I am going to be on my phone, I'm going to be on the Trend Mood and the Beauty News page, and I think on the Indie Makeup Spotlight as well. I don't know for sure, but maybe there's some Indie in here. I don't think it's going to be an extremely long video, but you never know with me. I can talk and talk and talk. But yeah, I'm going to see what the new makeup releases are all about. And please let me know down in the comments what you think of them as I go through them. So guys, let's just jump into the video and see what is up and new in the beauty community. Alright, we are going to start with something from Pat McGrath. She has announced a new eyeshadow palette in the big one, the Mothership line. It's the Divine Rose one. I think it's the seventh one. It's coming soon, it says, and I think it's going to be $120, as I believe. I have to check. I think it's going to be 120, but I think in the end it's just going to be 125, because, you know, but I've seen a few prices floating around. The thing is, I'm putting both of the pictures up. In the top picture, it looks much more brown. And I was like, ooh, okay, this is extremely wearable. Maybe this is going to be my first one then, because I really like Pat McGrath. It's just that I think that the colors are not always colors I'm going to use that much. And for this one, I was like, oh, it's really, really nice because it has more of these brown tones. But if you see the bottom picture, it's with the box and it's more rosy. Not necessarily making me sway from the palette, but it's a whole different story. So now I'll just have to wait and see when someone buys it, probably like Michelle Wong. Buys it, swatches it, uses it on her channel, and then I can definitely see what type of colors these shadows are going to be, and then I can make a decision, because off of this, I don't know. I seriously don't know. So I'm not going to put it on the wish list because of that, but it's like the first one I was like, okay, this is something I can use fully. All these shades are appealing to me. So I'm going to hold off until I know more. The next thing is by Linda Hallenberg. Linda Hallenberg has released, or I think it's going to be, yeah, it's available now. Fusion Crayons Kits, and it's in the Her Mood and Flash formula. The Flash formula is, I think, more of a shimmery metallic type of stuff. And the Mood one are just matte. So you've got the metallics and the mattes, and I really dig these colors. These colors are very appropriate for fall. But yeah, I think they're very, very intriguing. Their colors are really nice. I think these are colors I would use, especially during this time of year. Fall and winter, I have a very fall look today. I made it with the Desert Palette from 5050 Makeup. I'm going to show you with this palette. It's the Desert Palette. Very nice. It's not that expensive. They ship internationally and 50% of all the proceeds go to a charity. So I think that is lovely. I ordered this, I think, on Friday, and they are Rotterdam based. I live in Rotterdam as well. So they brought it over to my house and I think that is so sweet of them. I'm wearing their palette today. I made a little bit of a tutorial type of clip for my Instagram TV, I think. Yeah, it's going to be on my Instagram TV. And yeah, so if you want to see that, don't go check down my Instagram handle down below. And I think I'm going to put it up on the screen. I have to check. But yeah, back to Linda. I think I'm going to put it on the wishlist because I think these colors are really nice. And I believe that a lot of YouTubers I trust really enjoy her brand. So I really want to try her product. And I think this is a good place to start. Another thing that is going on the wish list, I'm not ordering them right now, and I think I'm going to regret it like you know, like you wouldn't believe, because I am on a bit of a no buy. It's the only thing I got was the desert palette, and it's like 12 euros or something. Very, very good deal. That's the only thing I bought because I don't want to spend any money before Black Friday, because I think it's just wasteful, basically. And I want to save up the money I would have spent this month to be able to spend that on the sales. So I haven't made a order for these, but they are going up right now for pre-order, and I think they're going to ship on the 18th of November. They're going to be £26 each, and they are the Lissa Eldridge New Velvet, and she made a True Velvet nudes collection, and it is stunning. You have Delicate Fawn, a Rosewood Nude, a Cocoa Brown one, a Light Pinky Berry, a Vivid Mulberry, and a and a Blackberry color. And the ones I really like is the Velvet Muse. That's the Rosewood one. I put the pictures up. And also the Velvet Beauty. That's the Light Pink Berry. And the Delicate Fawn. So Velvet Fawn is also calling my name, but it's so nude that I don't know if it's going to look good on me. But the thing is, I think with this range, she has announced them when she was releasing the pink ones, the summer ones, that this would be a great nude on everybody. But I don't know if I truly believe that. So the ones I am going to put on the wishlist are Rosewood Nude and the Light Pink Berry, and because I really think they are stunning. The names are Velvet Fawn, Muse, Decade, Beauty, Myth, and Midnight. And they go from left to right, bottom to top to bottom. So yeah. Okay. Then I have something from BH Cosmetics I'm actually not mad about. They have released their Fairy Lights Holiday Collection, and it is a palette, a shimmering body powder, and a brush set. And I kind of like it. There's an eyeshadow palette. I really like the eyeshadow palette. I think it's very like complete. You can make a few looks with this, but you've got everything you need. You've got enough transition shade, you've got enough pops of fun color, but you also got enough deeper shades to really make your look more constructed. So yeah, I really like this palette. I must say, I don't know if I want to get it per se, because I think I have a lot of these colors already, and I think I have them in better formulas by I don't want to say better brands, but by brands I enjoy a little bit more. But this is just one of the releases from BH Cosmetics I'm actually not mad about. And it's very affordable as well, because the Fairy Light Shadow is 20 euros. Oh no, sorry, $20 even. And the Fairy Light Shimmering Body Powder is $21. That is something I won't get, because I don't need a shimmering body powder. But you know, you go, you do your thing if you want to have it. And they have a brush set, and that is $26. I couldn't tell you anything about the quality of the brushes. The only thing I will say is that I think it's a very complete set. You've got everything for a full face and a full eye look. And it comes with this really nice little holder. So yeah, I don't think this is a bad release. It's not for me, but yeah, I think it's nice to see something from BH Cosmetics that I'm actually not that disappointed about. Then the next thing is also brushes, and it's from Milani. Milani have launched a 10-piece luxe brush set, and it looks really nice because the handles are very golden glittery. I think it's just a see-through handle with the glitters in it. It looks really, really nice. I have no idea how they perform. I've never used any Milani brushes. It's going to be $69.99. So it's for 10 pieces. So that comes down to like $7 a brush. If you don't have a very good collection of brushes, then maybe this could be for you. But as I said, I don't know if they perform very well. I think it's fun that they put this weird shape, like this angle shaped brush in there. It reminds me a bit of the Real Techniques one. You have like a three brush set from Real Techniques, who has the same thing, just a small, big, and a bigger one. And I think it could be really nice for contouring or highlighting if you, if you want to be more precise. So yeah, I don't think this is a very bad release. I think you've got everything you need, especially with BH Cosmetics one. It's just, I have a lot of brushes and I am leaning towards more high-end and luxury brushes because I don't want to spend money on cheaper brushes because I'm just that bitch. I'm sorry. So this is not going on the wish list. The next thing is I have seen that, and I probably you have seen it as well, that Norvina is going to release two mini palettes. And the mini volume 2 is the one with the oranges and the greens. And I think that is a very nice capsule of the third big palette she released. So that is going on my wish list for sure. It has already launched. It's going to be $29. And I think right now it's only available on Sephora and on the Anastasia website. I have no idea if it's going to come to Europe, the other stores, or if it's going to be on Beauty Bay or anything like that. I don't think it's limited edition, so I'm not going to rush to get it. I'm just going to put it on my list, and when I see it and it's on sale, because I like me a good sale, and I think during this time with Black Friday coming, the holidays, and especially after the holidays, there's going to be huge, huge sales as well. So please don't fall into this trap. If something is not limited edition and you don't need to get it, then please wait. Just sit on your hands, sit on your phone, sit on your bank account. Don't do it. Wait, because everything is going on sale eventually. And right now, in this time of year, you don't have to wait that long. So yeah, you have a volume 1 and a volume 2. And I think the volume 1 is more a capsule of the first one, the more purple pinkies one. And the volume 2 is the a capsule of the third one, the more orangey with greens. And I just really like that color story. And I have to say that if she just released everything right away, then she probably wouldn't have sold that many of the bigger palettes. But if she had done that, then yeah, I think a lot of fans would have appreciated a little bit more, because right now it's a little bit sloppy. I have talked about this last week, about the fact that Norvina is starting her own brand under the wings of Anastasia Beverly Hills, but everywhere you see the ABH still on there, so it's a bit confusing. It feels like it's just still one brand, but Norvina gets to play with some releases. I don't know. I think it's a shame that they're doing it the way they're doing it. I'm glad that I waited, I have to say, because I thought that the big Norvina palettes are a bit expensive. I think they're €60, but they're $60, and they're €75 here in Holland. That's insanity. So I'm not going to get them because of that. And that was why I didn't get them beforehand. So I'm quite glad that I waited, because now I know that I can get this small one for $29. And I get the gist of the palette. So yeah, I'm going to put this on the wishlist, the volume 2 one. And I'm going to go over to the next thing, because we have spent enough energy on Norvina and ABH. And the next thing is by ColourPop Cosmetics. Of course, we have a ColourPop release this week. And ColourPop has announced that they're going to add a Hyaluronic Creamy Concealer. And it's going to release on the 5th of November. That's, I think, on Tuesday. This Tuesday. And it's in their Pretty Fresh range. I think, is there already a foundation in the Pretty Fresh range? I don't know for sure. I don't really try a lot of ColourPop complexion products. I've had a bit of a haul type of moment when they had this sale around the summer, and I made a video about it. I have not gotten around to edit it yet, but it's coming, I think, this month. So it's a bit late, but it's coming. And usually when I order from ColourPop, it's just eye stuff and lip stuff. And maybe some blushes or something like that, but I don't really... Or I haven't really tried their complexion product, so I wouldn't be able to tell you if this is any good, yes or no. I have a lot of concealers I already want to try, and I've got a lot of my list that I already want to try, so I'm not going to put this on the wish list, but I think down the line I'm probably going to try it anyway. But yeah, it's not going on the wish list as such. The next thing is by Gimme Glow. Gimme Glow are launching a Thanksgiving collection, and it's called Fall Feast. It contains of 4 duos, and they will cost $10 each. So if you want to get them all, you will have to pay $40. I think that is quite okay for an indie brand, to be honest. I really, really think they are very fun colors, especially the pumpkin pie and whipped cream and the cranberry and stuffing. I think they're really nice, very fall colors. It's really like a true cranberry red. I think they look really, really cool. The cranberry one looks really, really cool. I think that the gravy and the glazed turkey and also the casserole and the spiked cider are really fun. It's just not colors I would wear that much when it comes to the casserole one. And I think if I wear them, I have it, so I don't need it. And the gravy and glazed turkey, I just have a lot. I have the Natasha Denona gold palette, and I've got the Biba palette, so I seriously don't need this because I have these colors already. But the top on, the pumpkin pie whipped cream and cranberry and stuffing, I really like. So if you want them, they are going to be launching at the 8th of November at 12 p.m. CST on Give Me Glow Cosmetics on their website. And I don't think I'm going to put them on the wish list, but I am going to, I already mentioned this before, but I am going to dabble more into indie brands for next year. I am going to buy more indie brands than I've been doing this year, because I've started getting into indie this year and I love, love, love what I got. So yeah, I'm going to not necessarily put them on the wish list, but I am going to try some Gimme Glow next year. Then By Terry have launched their holiday collection. It's called Starlight Rose, and they have released a few products in here. They are releasing a Glow Booster CC Cream for €69.50. A CC Illuminating Powder for €55, a Youth Glow Elixir for €175. Dang, that's bougie. Okay, then a Smoky Gold Eyeshadow Palette for €59, and Balm de Rose Travel Size for €16. Beauty Cracker for €29, and that comes, I think, with a gloss and a mascara, if I'm not mistaken. Then they have a brightening CC serum set in 2 shades, number 1 and number 4 for €69.50. A Balm de Rose set for €65. A Balm de Rose Ritual, that's €89. And a Hero Premium set, I think that contains just pretty much everything. That is going to be €350 or €349. Oh, we'll give you the euro. And then the Best Offset for €55. So if you want to get some By Terry, girl, you can. And you can get it on By Terry's website. And maybe it's coming to Sephora and stuff like that. But that doesn't say... so I don't know. I don't know. It's not going on the wish list. Then I'm going over to Kevin Aucoin. Kevin Aucoin has also released something for the holiday. It's called Jewel Pop, and it's containing a palette for $59, and you got some eyeshadows and 2 complexion products. I think a bronzer and a shimmery blush in 2 colors, so you can go either way or mix them. And you got some Jewel Pop Gloss Glow Mini Lip Collection, and that is going to be $25. And you get 4 shades. So yeah, that looks really nice. I've never tried anything by Kevin Aucoin. It's not something... The thing is, it's not something that is intriguing enough for me to try it and get it online. But it's a brand that has always intrigued me, because I have a book by Kevin Aucoin. So I think a makeup book about makeup techniques. So I think it's such a beautiful brand, really. I just haven't tried anything from it yet. And I am compiling a list of a few of these brands I've never tried anything from and seeing what 5 products I want to start off with. I'm thinking I'm going to make a video about it. So if you're interested, then let me know down below. And Kevin Kwan is going to be on that list because that is one of these brands that is really intriguing to me. But somehow I've never ordered anything. And I think it's because of it's not in store and it's not, as I said before, not intriguing enough to really get it online. So I'm trying to make a bit of a list and see, okay, what is everything they've got and what is it that I want to try? Because I think it's going to perform well. So yeah. Okay, so this is not going on the wish list. I'm sorry, but you know it's there. I think it's already available. Yeah, it's available now on Kevin Kwan and a website. But I don't know. I think it's going... Kevin Kwan is Sephora? I haven't got a clue. I think so. So you can get it anywhere Kevin Kwan is sold. You probably can get it there eventually. I'm not sure, but I think so. Then I'm going over to Paul and Joe. Paul and Joe have... I think it's going to be available and it's going to launch. It hasn't launched yet because it's going to launch on the 1st of... Oh, it has. It has. It launched on the 1st of November, so it's already available. And it's a hand cream in the cutest, cutest packaging ever. I've never tried anything by Paul and Joe, so I'm really contemplating on getting their advent calendar because you can get a lot of stuff in an advent calendar, and I think that is really nice. I think it's like, it's not even 100 euros. I think it's like 75 euros, something like that. It's on Beauty Bay. Don't go and buy it because I want to get it. So don't sell it out. I want to get it when, you know, the holidays sale is coming. Because it's like, you know, a lot of these advent calendars are going to go on sale after the holidays because they didn't sell out. So I'm going to wait. Don't go and get it and sneak it away from me. So yeah, I want to try Paul and Joe because I really think their packaging is really cute. And because that's the only reason I want to try it, I can't really justify getting the advent now. And it's the same with the hand cream. It's just a hand cream. So yeah, I don't see anything about prices, but it's just not something I use enough to put on the wish list or say that I'm going to buy it. It's just that the packaging is really cute. So yeah, and I am a sucker for packaging, as you know, as you know. Then I want to go to Urban Decay. They are going to release a party favor Moondust palette. I think their last Moondust palette was the very colorful one. And this is going to be a party favor one. It looks a lot more neutral. I have no idea if there are going to be some shifts in there. But it's coming soon and it's going to be $29. I'm going to read what it says about the product because to me it's just like 6 shimmers in neutral colors. So maybe there's something behind it. Okay, the 6 new shades include pearlescent and shimmering shades. They are in Neon Moon, Sugar High, No Shame, Spaced, Long Night, and Powder Trip that include microfine bits of iridescent sparkle and 3D metallics for a luxe diamond-like effect. Well, okay, that could be cool. It could be that you have a wearable shade with like extravaganza type of shimmer on it. That would be really cool. It's not something I'm going to put on the wish list. I'm just going to see if people swatch it, if it's going to be any good, yes or no. And yeah, if it's special enough to get. And if I will, I will get it on sale because yeah. I don't think this is going to sell out. I don't know what you think, but I don't think this is going to sell out. So yeah, I think I'm going to just wait and see what other people think of it and then maybe get it if I get the chance. All right, then Dior. Dior is going to release a Happy 2020 holiday collection. It is already available, so it's not a have, will launch, it's they have launched. It's going to be available in various retailers such as Bloomingdale's, Saks and Nordstrom. So I hope it's coming to Holland as well. So I can swatch it in store, gaga over it and not buy it. Somehow, I don't know about you, but somehow these very high-end luxury like makeup brands like Dior, Tom Ford, Chanel, those type of brands, I never buy eyeshadow from. I don't know why. Maybe I should, but it's always like I watch a lot of channels who are more into the like high-end and luxury brands, like Michelle Wang, Mel Thompson, also Charlotte Holdcroft. She's also more into the mid and high range, higher range makeup brands. And they never really seem to be that special for that price. So that's why I never try it. I always like to go in store and swatch them and then like, ooh, that's so pretty, but I'm not going to get it because it's way too expensive. And I can get this from either a indie brand or just MAC or something like that. And it's going to be just as okay. So yeah, but if you want it, then I'm going to tell you what it's all about. It's a Happy 2025 color palette and it's going to be limited edition. They're going to be dollars. I'm constantly saying that. $63. It's the Celebrate in Gold. That's the more wearable one. And the Party in Colors. 007. I don't know. They look very shimmery, really nice. But I'm not going to put it on the wishlist and I'm not going to get anything off this because of the reasons I said. So, yeah. Then move on. Let's move on to Chanel. Chanel is one of those brands I won't buy any eyeshadows from. I don't know why, because always when I'm there and I'm go to the Bijenkorf with a colleague of mine, she's like, oh, look at this, look at this. And I'm like, oh, that's so stunning. And I never get anything. Don't ask me why. It's just always I'm like, this is a bit expensive. But Chanel is also launching a holiday collection. They are releasing a eyeshadow quad that is going to be $65 and it has four lovely shades in there. But they're also going to release two mono eyeshadows that are going to be $36. And one is in gold, the other is in burgundy. They have very pretty French names that I'm not going to try to pronounce because I'm not good at that. I think the fact that they are releasing single eyeshadows is really nice because now it's $36 and that's a lot of money for one eyeshadow. But it's nice because then it's not the same amount as 63. So I might be persuaded to buy one of those. I have to swatch it first because if it's not special enough, I'm not going to get it, of course. Then they are going to release a eyeliner. It's the Stilo Jeu Waterproof Long Lasting Eyeliner. And it's going to be $33. And it's in Keiki Intense. Where's the eyeliner? Oh, it's on the bottom. It looks great to me. So I don't know what... I think Keiki is more of the like brownish... No, not brown. The cake is more of like the pants you wear when you go on survival stuff and stuff like that. So I don't know why it's called cakey, but okay. Let's move on. Let's not try to explain Chanel because you know. Okay, then they are going to release the Éclat Magnétique de Chanel Illuminating Powder. And it's going to be $17. I think it's just a finishing powder. Or is it a highlighter? Maybe it's a highlighter. Yes, it's a highlighter. It's an illuminating powder. So I think it's a highlighter and it's in a soft peach shimmer. That could be potentially very stunning. But it's $70 for a highlighter. So then they have a Rouge Allure lip color for $45. And that is going to be in 2, 4, 6 shades in all sorts of roses, corals, and reds. And then they have two nail polishes in a deep green and a rich red. They're going to be $28. And then they have a Rouge Coco Gloss for $30 in Rouge Garmin and Rouge Grenade. They look really pretty. And the lipsticks, you know, that's the thing with Chanel. It's all really pretty. It's just all really expensive as well. So I don't, I'm not going to put it on the wish list and I don't think I'm going to get anything from this. I think if I was a very rich woman, I would, but no. We're going over to Milk. Milk has partnered up with CS and I don't really know what that is. Oh, Sephora Collection, With Sephora Collection, sorry, I didn't know that. I don't have Sephora in Holland, so I'm not that, well, you know, known with Sephora stuff, but Milk Makeup, and Sephora have partnered up and they have created their first ever brushes. There are 5 brushes. I must say they look really nice. They look really luxe and they are all face brushes. So you have a foundation brush, a concealer brush, a cream sticks brush, a highlighter brush, and a setting powder, say it with me, brush. Okay, and it's going to be available online for $58 for the whole set. And I must say, of course, $58 is a lot of money, but I think that for 5 face brushes, if it's any good, I have no clue if it will be, but if it's any just slightly okay, then I think it's an okay price. They look really nice. You got this, I think this container that holds the brushes, I think you get it with it. So yeah, I think it's really nice. I've tried some Milk products lately and yeah, I like the brand. It's not something I can get in Holland. I don't even think I can get it shipped here, but if I get abroad and I can get the brand in stores, then I do. And I what I get, I like. So yeah, I can't say anything about the quality of these brushes. I can only say that they look really nice and I think that it's quite reasonable price-wise. Okay, now, I think I have only two things left to talk about, and I'm finally getting to the Jeffree Star and Shane Dawson conspiracy and controversy, I think the other one is called, collection that has already launched and already broke the internet. It's a big range of bags, all sorts of merch type of stuff, but of course I am only going to talk about the eyeshadow palettes and the lip products, because I think the lip products, for me, I think they look really nice, and I think that's always a bit the thing with Jeffree Star's lip stuff. I think it always looks really nice, but I also always hear that it's very drying on your lips. Now, don't go standing on me, because I really like Jeffree Star stuff. I just don't like liquid lips that is very drying and feels like paint on my lips. So that is something I'm going to skip. Maybe, just maybe, I'm going to get the Ryland shade and maybe the Andrew shade. But I'm just going to wait. It's a permanent collection. I can't get anything anymore because they broke the internet. And I must say, I have been watching this documentary with my sister and we've had a blast. And yes, there are people arguing that this whole Shane Dawson thing is just one big commercial for these palettes. But dang, aren't they smart in doing business? I think it's very, very nice to see their friendship. I'm totally not a fan of Jeffree Star per se. It's not like I'm standing over Shane Dawson, but I think that this friendship of theirs is kind of cute. I think it is really nice and very informative about, you know, the documentaries about what happens in the makeup industry and as a makeup lover and as a avid, I don't want to say fan, but I think it's just fun to look how this business works. It's not just the makeup business, because you've got like the brands I was just talking about, like Dior, like Chanel, they don't do it like that. So there is a makeup business and you've got the influencer makeup business. And I think that this whole thing of YouTube and of these influencer brands and seeing what happens and seeing what's happening behind the scenes and seeing how much money people make just by being on YouTube. And I have to admit, I am someone, I think I watch more YouTube than I watch regular television. So for me, I think it's extremely interesting to see what is happening on the business side of it all. So that's my 2 cents, take it as you will, but I have to say that I think it's hilarious and I think it's really fun to watch this documentary, and I think it's nice to see a side of Shane Dawson and get to know Shane Dawson a little bit more and also see sides of Jeffree. I'm like, okay, Yeah, he's a bit creepy in a way, but I also think he's just a guy and he's just someone who has been through a rough patch in life, and I think it's cool to see someone like that succeeding the way he does. So you can think about it what you want. I don't care. That is just my two cents and my opinion about it. And I want to talk to you about, I have been talking about the lip products, and I want to talk to you about the eyeshadow palettes. I think they look nice. It's just not something I would have gone rushed out and get, because, as I said before, everything goes on sale at some point. This is not limited edition, so you don't need to get it now. Come on, unless you are a YouTuber and you need to get it on your channel as fast as you can get it on your channel because you want more views and you want more subscribers, then maybe it's worth getting through that whole hassle that has happened with the internet breaking, with like hours of waiting in line and in line online to get this stuff and all the stress that came with that. I'm sorry, I'm not about that life, so I'm not doing that. I am just going to wait until these lovely babies are going to go on sale, and then maybe I get it. It's the same with the Jawbreaker palette. I think the Jawbreaker palette is going to be on sale this Black Friday. I'm going to watch for it. When it first released, I talked about it on one of these episodes, and I was like, no, I don't need it. I don't want to get it. And still, I'm like, yeah, well, I don't want to get it for the price that they're selling it, but I want to get it when it's on sale because it has some fun colors. I just don't need it. And that's something I think is a lot to do with all these consumerism and hyped up consumerism. Just hold on to your horses, see if it's limited edition, and then just wait because it goes on sale eventually. And yeah, I must say, if you look at the palettes themselves, I think the bigger one, the conspiracy one, I think you can get some looks that are cohesive, but not a lot. Because yes, you've got some nice transition shades, but they're very light. So you don't have a nice deep brown. You only have the plum, the, what's it called? I don't know. The plummy color. So yeah, that's, but you have the tea or Illuminati. Is that, no, my, I'm sorry. In the smaller one, in the conspiracy, or no, not the conspiracy, the controversy, the mini controversy, there is somewhat like a deeper brown. It's the teapot one. Yeah, I think if you have them both together, then maybe you can make some more cohesive looks with them. But I think that if you are really looking for a more well-rounded palette, you can go, it's safer to go with the mini controversy one than with the bigger conspiracy palette, because you would always have to get some other palettes in there to make a cohesive look. I don't think that's a bad thing. I'm not totally not saying that's a bad thing, because yeah, I like to use palettes that way. I like to have a nice palette, and if it's agreeing with me, or I like what I'm seeing and I like the colors and I want to have it, I don't really mind if I can't make a full look with just one palette, because I've got like a shitload of palettes already. I can just pull another palette and, you know, make a cohesive look with another palette together. You know what I mean? So yeah, for me, it's like, if you want to have a palette that is going to make a complete look every time, you can do a lot with it. I don't think this is the collection to get. Maybe the mini controversy, but then still you're a little bit limited, but you can. The thing is though, it's a little bit more wearable, these palettes, but yeah, no, I think you've got, I think, yeah, it's just, I don't need it. So I think I'm going to wait for it to go on sale. And if it does, then I might pick it up, because I think it's fun to just collect the stuff. And yeah, that is not a very good reason to want something, but that's just me. So I'm sorry. Okay, enough talk about Jeffrey and Shane. The last thing on my list is just more of a news type of thing. It's not going on the wishlist because I have it already, and it's the Hourglass Lighting Edit Unlocked, and it's in the ghost packaging. I think it's going to be limited edition again, but it is the their face palette, the one they had last Christmas in the gold packaging. I got that one. I'm wearing it, the bronzer and the lighter shades, the two bronzer shades I'm wearing today. This palette is stunning. I'm not going to tell you it's worth the $80. I'm not going to say that, but if you're going to spend it, I don't think you are going to mind. Because, yeah, it's really pretty. And the quality is there. So yeah, it's launching. It has already launched on the 1st of November. I hope it's still available. It's on Hourglass Cosmetics on their website. And I have no idea if it's going to come to Sephora or any other retailers that sell Hourglass. So yeah, if you want to get it, I have no... Shall I check? I'm going to check for you. No, I can't find it on their... Okay, well, I'm sorry, I can't find it on their website, so I wouldn't know if it's still there or not. So, but guys, that's it for me for this week. I hope you enjoyed this video. So if you did, then please like it. Give it a thumbs up. So that really helps me get pushed into the algorithm and reach more people. So please give this video a thumbs up if you liked it. Thank you so much for watching, and I hope you will consider subscribing. If you don't, then that's okay also, but I hope I will see you in my next video. Bye!